Hello, everyone. Welcome to the English devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. Let's begin in prayer. Heavenly Father, I come before you asking forgiveness of my sins so that my prayer can reach your holy throne. Thank you, Father God, for this day that you have given us. Thank you for your mercy being new every morning. I ask you, Father God, that you will speak to us through this devotional. Let us understand what we are reading, what we are learning. Help it to be a part of our transformation. Help us, Father God, to understand your word, to understand when your Holy Spirit is talking to us. Help us, Father God, to put into practice the things that we are learning so that our lives can be surely transformed into your likeness, so we can be worthy of our calling. Father, these things I ask in your Son's name. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Today's devotional is titled, God Rewards Your Effort. It was written by Moise Bentacourt and translated by Maria Elena Cardona. Our biblical base is found in Luke chapter 2, verses 36 through 38. So says the Word of God. Now there was one Anna, a prophetess, the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher. She was of great age and had lived with a husband 7 years from her virginity. And this woman was a widow of about 84 years, who did not depart from the temple, but served God with fasting and prayers night and day. And coming in that instant, she gave thanks to the Lord and spoke of him to all those who looked for redemption in Jerusalem. Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the scripture. Isaías Ugarte was an old woman who many times had been advised not to fast anymore, as her health was deteriorating by the day. One morning, Isaías' joy caught the attention of Onelia Gomez, who was on her way to meet Isaías. Isaías said to her, "Oh, Onelia, the things I would miss out on if I did not fast. At dawn, a voice woke me up saying, 'Isaías, you have visitors from God.' And when I opened my eyes, I could see three angels at the foot of my bed who gave me a word from heaven. What a joy, Onelia! I don't want to stop praying and fasting for anything in this world." Hearing this testimony of an elderly woman whose health was deteriorating challenged me. Let us add a new effort each and every day. Every day having new possibilities so that when the Lord comes, He finds us making that effort. In doing so, we will be blessed. God sees your effort and He will always reward you. Amen. My brothers and sisters, whatever it is that we do by faith for the Lord, He is going to reward us. If our faith is fasting, as the church has suggested that we fast, then fast that much. If our faith is little and we can only fast a little bit, then fast the little that you can. Each and everything that we do for the Lord in honest effort, He is going to reward. It might be that right now, you are only able to fast a few hours a day, or you are only able to do such and such that God wants you to do very little, but do so in faith, and He is going to increase your faith, and He is going to increase your ability to do more and more for Him. I used to always get caught up on the fact that the church wants us to fast for 18 hours a day. 18 hours on Sunday, Wednesday, Friday, and sometimes even a special fast during the week for whatever reason. And I used to think, Lord, I can't do that. 18 hours? First of all, I have a chronic illness that did not allow me to fast very much. I had to take medication. I had to eat at certain times. I had to eat certain things or my blood pressure would drop and I would pass out and then it would be a whole big mess. I couldn't do it. So I decided that I might not be able to fast for 18 hours, but I can fast for 8 or for 10. And then eventually that grew. I am somebody who, because of my medical conditions, I have to drink a lot of water during the day or my blood pressure drops. And so I would do a modified fast. The church says no water, no nothing to drink, no nothing to eat for 18 hours. But I told the Lord, Lord, I'm going to do what I can do. You know my medical issues, but I am doing this by faith. And so I would fast the 18 hours, but I would drink my water. And you know what? The Lord blessed me for the little that I was able to do by faith. The Lord blessed me. Eventually, because of my faith, I firmly believe that because of my faith, the Lord decided to heal certain parts of me so that I could eventually fast the 18 hours that the church recommends. And then beyond that, eventually I was able to fast for 24 hours, then 48 hours, and then 72 hours. So my brothers and sisters, whatever that you can do right now, do it with faith. Don't think about, oh, I can't do it just like the church says, so I'm not going to do it at all. No, my brothers and sisters, by faith, do what you can, and God is going to bless you. God is going to reward you, and God is going to give the ability for you to do it as recommended. But do it by faith, trusting in the Lord that He is going to do what is best for you. The Lord may call you to do something a little bit different than what the church is recommending. The church recommends 18 hours fast. God may be telling you to do a 24-hour fast. So if God is telling you to do that 24-hour fast, He is going to give you the ability and the desire to do it. So start out small, start out by faith, and see where God takes you. He is going to reward everything that you do by faith in obedience to Him. Amen. May the Lord receive the honor and the glory.
I am surrounded on every side. Can't see the light of day, but I am persuaded beyond all hope you won't let go of me. I stake my claim on every word you say, you will not be late. I will sing through fire and thunder, 'cause you are on. Trust you with my life. I know my story, it isn't over. Even against all odds, you are a faithful God. You're faithful, God. The darkest of weather, still believe you're good, so I'm moving forward through crashing waves. I know I'm safe with you. You hold my life, you hear my cry with every breath inside. I will sing through fire and thunder, 'cause you are on my
promises will hold together, and I will dwell in the hope of your love forever. I am convinced that your promises will hold together, and I will dwell in your love. And I will sing through fire and thunder, 'cause you are on my side. I trust you with my life.
Amen, what a beautiful song. And now, my brothers and sisters, I invite you to check out our YouTube channel, SCC English Ministry, for the daily Bible reading, which can be found in Exodus chapter 17, 18, and 19. And now we ask that the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of his children, now and forever. Amen.